Delonte wasn't lying. He called in a few favors and arranged for me to get out early. Knocked almost 4 years off my sentence. Now, Joe used to come visit me and, you know, kind of fill me in on what was happening on the outside. But I tell you, as soon as I walked out of that prison gate, it was like a whole new world.
Yeah. Look, whatever you're selling, pal, I ain't interested.
No. My name's Vito Scaletta. I'm looking for...
Oh, right. Francesca's brother. She told me you were in jail.
I'm out now. And you are?
Francesca's husband, Eric. Your sister ain't here. She must be out shopping or something. I'll, tell her you stopped by. See ya.
Yeah, if that guy wasn't married to my sister Maron...
Have you heard the music they're playing on the radio nowadays? It's just not decent. I think it's kind of neat. Shame on you. It's the work of the devil. We need to put a stop to it. What about the children? We can't just stop people from making music, you know? People like to make music. People like to do a lot of things. That doesn't mean you ought to let them. But what will we do without music? Music? Well, people want music, they can go to church. We should just all listen to the good book and do what it says. Then life would be simpler. Sure would. We'd all be at home, barefoot, pregnant, and chained to the stove. See you at the service on Sunday. Bright and early. Get out of here!
Vito!
Hey, you break out of jail?
Ah, jeez, good to see you in regular clothes and on the right side of the bars again. Welcome home. Come on in.
Man, I tell you, lots changed since I went away.
Yeah, I guess it has. And hey, it ain't much, but I hooked you up with a nice little apartment, just like you
Thanks.
Said. Now I got a surprise for you. We're going out tonight to celebrate, and I'm going to introduce you to somebody.
Yeah, sounds good to me.
You're going to need a little cash so you can get things going again. I got a piece for you, too, if you want it. Ah, here. Always comes in handy. So, what do you want to do now that you're a free man?
Hey, what do you think? I want to go back to working with you again.
All right. I was worried they might have turned you straight in there.
I actually met a lot of people and learned a lot while I was on the inside. Got a much better idea of how things work now.
Good thing, because I wasn't exactly sitting around on my ass while you was in there. Don't worry, though. I'll show you the ropes, like always.
All right, well, what are we waiting for? Let's go.
Jesus, I didn't expect you to be raring to go like this, but what the hell? Come on, let's go see your new place. We'll take my car and go meet your new landlord. You do the driving so you can get back into the swing of things. Just hope you didn't forget how to drive while you was in the can.
Hey, what are you worried about? It's like riding a bicycle.
Sure, but when you smack up your bicycle, it don't cost a fortune to fix the friggin' thing.
All right, I get it. You're like an old lady.
Yeah, I sure as hell hope so. And if you ain't noticed, cars are a lot different since you went away. You'll see. Your new place is just down the street, right near the boardwalk. You're gonna love it. Damn, it's good to have you home. I'd done pretty good while you was locked up. But now that you're out, the sky's the limit.
You seen Henry lately?
Nah, not for a few years now. He really felt bad about what happened, you know.
So what you been up to? We couldn't really talk about much when you visited me.
Well, after the shit Clemente and that little asshole Luca tried to pull on us, I got hooked up with the Falcone family and I started working for them.
Really?
Yeah, you'll see tonight. I told you, I got a nice surprise plan for you. But don't bother asking, because I ain't gonna tell you.
Oh, boy.
Don't worry. I've been planning this for weeks.
That's what I'm afraid of.
ECLA, Empire Bay's News Home. I'm Gary Stevens. Today marks the official end to the war with Japan. 6 years after the fighting stopped, the San Francisco Peace Treaty officially put an end to the war with Japan and ensured that the island nation would never again pose a threat to the security of other nations. The treaty also allocated money to victims of war crimes at the hands of Japanese military personnel. For Empire Bay's news leader, ECLA, I'm Gary Stevens.
All right, this is close enough. Park here. Go check the place out. It's on the top floor. I already paid the first month's rent for you. And hey, the entrance to your garage is on that side street over there.
Thanks, Joe. I appreciate it.
Hey, and about tonight, we're going to a real classy joint. So buy yourself a nice suit. They won't let you in this place looking like an ex-con.
My kind of place.
Okay, here we are. I'm sure you'll find it to your liking. I live in a similar apartment myself. As you can see, it even comes with a telephone at no extra charge. And here's the bathroom, clean and modern, with all the hot water you could ever want. And here is the master bedroom. And there is the master's bed. It's comfy, with room enough for two. Maybe three. And it doesn't squeak. Always a plus in my book. I sure hope you like your new apartment, sir. If you have any questions, feel free to ask.
Just one question. When are you leaving?
Now, if you'll pardon me, I have to go and check out another client. Goodbye now.
Yeah, see ya.
I really hope this guy shows up soon. I've got a lot on my plate today, and the housing market is booming.
vehicle.
Get out of the vehicle.
Time once again for the Empire Central Radio News
Vehicle
break.
Vehicle theft in progress. Get the suit of suspect.
Well, the rock and roll crew just keeps getting bigger and bigger, just as your old pal Rockin' Ricky Fox predicted. And if you need proof, kids, you need to look no further than the scene at the Dundary Theater today, as kids were pressed skirt to shirt and filled the famed Midtown Landmark for one rock and roll show. How big was it? Well, Rockin' Ricky Fox is about to tell you. This show was the biggest this DJ has ever... seen, and I've seen a lot, believe me you. So, here's to even bigger shows to come. For Empire Central Radio, this is Rockin' Ricky Fox. Rock and roll! Once again for the Empire Central Radio News Break, this is Rockin' Ricky Fox. Hey kids, the traitorous Julius and Ethel Rosenberg were finally executed late last week. The first ever execution of civilians for the crime of espionage came after the married couple were found guilty of passing American nuclear secrets to the Soviets. Of course, they were sentenced to die in the electric chair. Bet they got a charge out of that verdict. For Empire Central Radio News, I'm Rockin' Ricky Fox.
Hey, welcome. So, something I can do for you? Right away. Here you go. Pick a design. Hey, you looking for a new set of wheels? Take your pick, pal. Fixed up, buddy. What is new? Supercharger, baby. That's the juice.
Who's there?
It's me, Vito.
All right, come in.
Hey, look at you. Hello, Vito. Hey, don't forget the ammo, too, huh? An excellent weapon. Like my mom always said, you can never have too much ammo. The Thompson submachine gun. If it was good enough for the big guys, then it's good enough for you. Am I right? Whoa! You're turning into my number one customer.
Condemns rock and roll craze. Extra! Russian spy sentenced to death. Extra! 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 Heir to Swift Cola Empire lost at sea. Here you go, buddy.
Thanks.
Extra! Masked robbers terrorize diner. Extra! Extra! MacArthur slams Truman in leaked letter. Extra! Extra! Cannons score 4 in the ninth to beat the Bulls 5-3. Extra! Read all about it. Truman dismisses MacArthur. Extra! Governor claims prostitution rife in Empire Bay. Extra! Cigarette shipment vanishes from Oyster Bay. Extra! Russian spy sentenced to death. Extra! Extra! Lost heaven. Students protest.
I'm here to tell you about the Empire Electronics 45 series television. The new 45 series features a new picture system that's going to be the biggest thing since sliced bread. Of course, I'm talking about color television. Yes, folks, the technology of tomorrow is here today. The 45 series TV brings you a full-color picture inside a handsome cherry wood box. It's the most picture you could ever ask for, and it'll be the last television set you'll ever need. So stop by your local appliance store today and fall in love with the new color picture and handsome design of the Empire Electronics 45 series television. Your eyes will thank you.
Geez, I thought you was gonna be a no-show. Not bad, nice material.
Thanks. So, what's the plan for tonight?
You'll find out. A friend of mine's coming to pick us up. I met him when you was on your little vacation. And show him some respect. He's kind of an important guy.
Oh, yeah?
You'll see in a minute. Here he comes.
Hey, Joe.
Hey, Eddie.
Here I am.
How's it going?
Not too bad, not too bad. Oh, this your buddy?
Yeah, this is my pal Vito. Vito, this here is a good friend of mine, Eddie Scarpa.
Nice to meet you, Eddie.
Same here, Vito. Okay, fellas, I'm dying for a drink. Let's go. Hey, Vito, you want to drive? I had a couple of drinks already. So, you tell him where we're headed, Joey?
Nope. All he knows is that it's a surprise.
He's gonna love it.
I fucking hope so. Unless he got into the, funny business in a can.
Hey, what are you two talking about?
Don't worry about it. You'll see.
Hey, come on. We might as well tell him now.
Hey, you waited this long. We'll tell him in the car. All right. Let's go, Vito.
Hey, you know, it would help if you told me where we're going.
Head to Oyster Bay.
Okay, so Vito, what was the one thing you missed the most when you was in the camp?
Freedom.
Yeah, well, but besides that?
You know, booze, broads, baseball, everything.
Now you're getting closer.
What are you guys, taking me to a baseball game?
No, we're taking you to the classiest cat house in the city, Vito.
Cat house, huh? Wow.
Well, you don't sound too excited, Vito. Come on, don't tell me you don't want to have some fun after all that time.
Hey, don't worry, Vito. These girls are real professionals. If you forgot how to do it, they'll get you back in shape in no time.
We're gonna have a ball. Oh, hey, remind me not to drink too much. There's something I gotta take care of later.
What's more important than pussy and boots?
You know how it is. Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. Hey, Vito, come on, step on it, eh? So I talked to Leo Galanti about you, Vito. He said you were a real stand-up guy, and he told me all about the shit that Clemente tried to pull on you guys. But between you and me, why'd you get into that line of work? I mean, we all got our reasons.
Well,
Yeah, yeah.
Because, you know, I don't want to end up like my old man, and,
Oh, no. Yeah.
Look, I figure nobody's gonna help me, so I gotta help myself.
You do. Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay, Scram, baby.
So, Vito, listen. I work for Carlo Falcone, and, we're looking to expand our operation. Joe's been working for us for a while now, and, since you're a friend of his, we'd like to extend that offer to you as well. What do you say?
Yeah, sure, I'm interested.
All right, let's drink to it. Here's to you guys.
All right.
And to a bright future together.
Touching down.
I can't be drinking too much tonight. I got some business to take care of. Carlo's a real smart guy. He's into, astrology.
You mean astronomy?
Fuck you, you fucking cum dumpster.
Sorry, ladies. Looks like I gotta get going.
Shut your goddamn pie hole. If you wanna use your mouth.
You fellas ready to go?
Vito! Yeah, let's go. Hey, get up, Joe! If you had to be there 20 years ago, I'm going home. Good night, you whores! Hey, where the hell is my car? Somebody stole it! Hey, call the fucking cops, man.
You're staring at it, you lush.
Huh? Oh, yeah, good. Hey, where's my keys?
Vito's gonna drive. He's the least fucked up out of all of us.
Yeah! Next time for us, Joe. More pussy, less booze. So, how'd you like the place, Vito? A
lot better than playing I just zeech in the showers, huh? What the hell's that stink? Eddie, you puke?
What? I wouldn't puke in my own car.
What the hell is that smell then?
Oh, yeah, I'm smelling it too.
Must be Frankie Potts.
What? That asshole puked in your car?
Nah, he's in a trunk.
What?
What?
Hey, it's all your fault, Joey. I told you I had some fucking business to take care of, and you went and got me drunk.
Hey, since when does business to take care of mean dead guy in the trunk?
Hey, whoa. Hey, calm down, Vito. Hey, I spent it. We'll figure something out.
What's to figure? All we gotta do is bury the stiff. I already got his spot picked out, up by the old observatory.
You got a shovel?
Sure, it's in the trunk. And the hole is already dug. All we need to do is chuck him in and cover him up.
All right. Where's this hole?
A little ways outside of town, there's a path in the forest to a small clearing. That's where the hole is. And hurry it up, will ya? God, I need some fresh air. The stench back here is fucking killing me. Stop.
Now, I'm gonna hurl.
Jesus, where's this shit coming from?
Oh, shit. Whoa, I don't remember eating calamari.
Can't hold your booze, can you?
Pursuit of a speeding vehicle.
Copy that.
All right, shut the car off and get out of there. You know, I'm gonna have to give you a fine for this.
Thank you, officer.
Do yourself a favor, pal, and straighten up.
Hey, Dick. Did you hear about President Truman?
What about him?
He just approved the production of the hydrogen bomb.
Really? First I've heard of it.
You didn't get the Empire Times this morning, did you, Dick?
Why, no. No, I didn't.
Don't be like Dick. Get the Empire Times delivered to your door daily and stay informed. The Empire Times, all the news you need to know.
All right, we're here.
Vito, go pop the trunk.
Is that a joke? That's great. That's just great. Yeah.
No. God damn it, new shoes.
Oh,
Jesus Christ. Oh, fucking Christ almighty! How long this guy been in here, Eddie?
Just a couple days.
You're gonna have to get him out of there, Vito.
That's just great.
I can't handle the smell.
Some fucking welcome home this is.
Oh. Oh.
Whoa! Hey, mother. Hey, here's a hole. Right here. Dump him in.
Finally, done. Okay, now who's gonna bury him?
What?
I give me a minute to get a hold of myself. Can you just do it? Every time I get a whiff of the guy, makes me have to puke. And Eddie's not gonna be any help here.
Fine, whatever.
Hey, fellas. How about a little music, eh?
You gotta be kidding me.
Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go.
This wasn't supposed to be part of your homecoming party, but it's nice out here, ain't it? Well, I ain't been in the woods for a while.
Yeah, you won't be liking it so damn much after I smack you with this shovel.
Oh, Vito, do not change that station.
kidding me with this?
Return to me.
It's only my favorite song, Scott.
For my day,
Sorry, Vito. Not exactly the best way to end the night, huh? But thanks. I owe you one, big time. Leave Eddie's car here so he can get home in the morning.
You're a good man, Vito. I'll settle up with you tomorrow. Hey, you coming in for some drinks?
It's 3 in the morning! Shut the hell up!
Hey, shut up, you whore! Come on!
You had enough, Eddie. You're going to bed. Come on. I'll call you tomorrow, Vito. Good night.